Keeping track of current and potential customers is extremely important for any business, and this application will help you achieve the same. Hi guys, welcome to AppDNA, where we talk about all things apps. My name is Akshay, and the application that we are going to take a look at today is Customer Relationship Management, or CRM. We'll be using Zoho Creator, which is a low-code application development platform, to create our CRM application. The minimal coding, easy-to-use interface, and drag-and-drop features of Zoho Creator will help us make applications quick and easy. Let's take a look at the main features of our CRM application. The application will be able to keep track of leads, contacts, conversions, sales, and orders. The application will also help in creating events and campaigns with consumer or customer participation. So without further ado, let's get started and create our own CRM application. Page of Zoho Creator, and we'll be creating the application from scratch. Let's name our application as CRM. CRM stands for Customer Relationship Manager. And it's time for us to create our first form, which will be a database of leads. So we'll name our form as Add Leads. We'll be dragging and dropping a drop down for lead status. So we're giving four choices here, and the choices are new, nurturing, won, and lost. We'll be giving the basic fields such as name, phone number, address, a single line field for business name, another phone number for official number, email, a link to their website, office address, and finally another drop down field for lead type. We'll be adding the next form, which is the add new sales rep form. So we need to map the leads with the sales rep. So first we need a database of all sales reps. We'll be dragging and dropping the name and email, the add new contact form. We'll be dragging and dropping a lookup field for the contact owner, which is a sales rep. We'll be dragging and dropping a name field, email, phone number, address. So we'll come back to this form as we need to add one more lookup of the account name. Account name is the name of the business or the company. So for that, we need to add the add new account form. So let's add that. We'll be dragging and dropping another lookup field for account owner, which is the sales rep. We'll be dragging and dropping a single line field for the account name or the business name, an email field for account email. We'll be also dragging and dropping URL for website, phone number, address, and also lookup of contact name from the add new contact form. Now we'll be adding the account lookup in the add new contact form. Now it's time for us to add the next form, which is the add new event form. We'll be dragging and dropping a single line field for subject, a multi-line field. We'll also be dragging and dropping two rodeo fields. We'll also be dragging and dropping two radio fields for status and target audience. And we'll be dragging and dropping two daytime fields for from and to, and one more single line field for location. So our first workflow will be on the add new lead form, and we'll name our workflow as assign owner. we'll be doing it on load. So let's type our delete script and I'll explain to you. So here we are mapping the lead owner from the add new sales rep form, and we are giving the email as zoho.login user ID, and we are disabling the field. So the lead owner will automatically appear there and it will not be subject to any manipulation as we are disabling the lead owner field. So people will not be able to select the lead owner. It will automatically appear there. So let's save our workflow. We'll be adding the next workflow in the add new account form, and we'll be naming our workflow as assign account owner. So we need this custom action to perform when the form loads, and we'll be giving on load. Let's type our deluge script. Here I am fetching information from the add new sales rep form for the account owner, and I am disabling it. This is pretty much the same as what we did in the assign lead owner, and we have saved our workflow. We assigned the lead owner and the account owner. We'll be assigning the contact owner as well. The process is exactly the same, except for the fact that instead of lead owner or account owner, it's contact owner this time. We have saved our workflow. Add new event form. It is important to notice that in the report, we need an initial status before we assign a status. So that particular status will be scheduled. We'll name our workflow as assign initial. We'll add a new action on success, and we'll give input.status is equal to scheduled. Click on save and our workflow is saved. So we have completed doing all the workflows on the forms. Now it's time for us to go to the backbone of this application, which is creating functions for reports. So it's time for us to add a particular action. We'll name the action item as convert, so that when we click on convert, the lead gets converted. We'll add a new action. Let's type the delete script. So here, if you click on convert, this workflow will let you convert that particular lead into each field here with information from add new account form and add new contact form. The organization address becomes the address, the business name becomes the account name, and similarly in the add new contact form, the phone number, address, name, email, etc. reflects information from the add new contact form. So let's click on save. It has appeared here, and we can go to layout and add it as a field. Now we have to create an item in the add new event field, so that if your organization is planning a campaign or an event, we need to email everybody in the mailing list depending on whether they are leads, contacts, or accounts. So for that, we need a campaign button or an email button in the all new events report. So for that, we need to add a new action. We'll be naming our action item as email. So we need to add leads, contacts, and accounts to the mailing list. So we need to be doing workflows which contains information about all of these. So first, we'll be doing the workflow for leads, event rec as the variable here. So if target audience is leads, then once we click on the button mail, the status should reflect as completed, and the mail will be sent from the login user ID. Moreover, we have given a subject field and a description field in the add new event form. So we'll be giving the subject and the message as the subject field and the description field, the add new event form. We have also given from timings and to timings in the add new event form. Even that information will reflect here. Now, since we have done this for leads, we need to do it for contacts and accounts as well. So here I have given else if, and I've given information about contacts and accounts. It is done very much in the similar fashion, except that the to address is account email, and here the to address is the contact email. Let's save this workflow and add this item to the report. And we have saved it. So let's click on done. We'll be doing this on condition, so we need to give status equals schedule because that is the initial status here. So let's create the item. The item has appeared here. We'll be renaming the field as campaigns. So we are done building our CRM app. So all the information that you add here in the add new leads will reflect here under all new lead. To convert a particular lead, this is the custom action that we did so that it gets converted into an account or a contact. If you click on new events, you'll be able to add a new event. Let's give the status and we'll give leads as the target audience. See all this information here under all new events form, and this is the other custom function that we did. And if you click on email, the email has been sent and the status has reflected here from scheduled to completed. So we'll not be able to send email to a target audience that we've already sent. So now it's time for us to check whether our email function works. I am checking the email ID that I've given over here and I have received an email, and if you click on it, it is coming from the admin user ID and it is showing the dates and the deadlines that we have given for that particular campaign along with the subject that we have given here. So our email function is working absolutely fine. A CRM application which will act as a database of leads, contacts and accounts along with sales representatives, and you will be able to convert leads into accounts and contacts. Moreover, you will be able to add campaigns or events along with your customers by targeting a particular audience depending on whether it's leads, accounts or contacts. So that's it guys. Thank you for hanging out with me all this while. I hope that this CRM application will help in managing and improving the relationship with your customers. Also, if you want to take a look at a CRM application with much more features, which is much more comprehensive, please take a look at the one in the app deck page of Zoho Creator. Also, don't forget to subscribe to AppDNA channel if you want to see more videos like this. Till next time, goodbye.